Jesus Christ said, the hour cometh, but now is. You're waiting someday for someday for the trumpet to sound. But now is the day of salvation. Don't let this day pass you by. Amen. You don't know what awaits you at the road out there. But you have a wonderful chance. Before we blow the trumpet, can we read John chapter 2, please? We'll read John chapter 2, verse 15. We are still here. You can sit down. We are still here on earth. Praise the Lord. We'll read John 2. And somebody volunteer to read for me. Yes, from 15 to 18. And then somebody else. Nehemiah chapter 4, verse 20.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Joel chapter 2, from verse 15.
Yes.
And the altar, let them say, spare the people, Lord. Do not make your inheritance an object of scorn, a byword among the nations, among the peoples. Now the people would say, where is their God? The Lord's answer is this, verse 18. Then the Lord was jealous for his land and looked, and he took pity on his people. The Lord replied to them, I am sending you grain, new wine, and olive oil enough to satisfy you fully.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Let the bridegroom leave. The chambers and the bride. It's not time for honeymoon. Like our daddy just said, it's time for the church to stand. It's time for the church to take the fire back in. We should not die cold. Hallelujah. I want all the pastors, please, let all the ministers between the porch and the altar come and cry before the Lord. Spare your people. Why should the unbelieving nations? Why should the unbelievers, why should they continue to ask us, where is our God? Blow the trumpet, sound an alarm. The MC said, when the alarm sounds, we gather outside. One day, this alarm will sound and we gather to Christ Jesus. Nehemiah chapter 4 verse 20 says, wherever you hear the sound of the trumpet, gather, rally to us there, and our God will fight our battle. That world has not changed. We are not sounding much alarms these days. We are painting the people beautifully when there is danger. We need to sound the alarm. Can I ask the ministers, please? As we sound the alarm, we should cry to the Lord. Have mercy on your church. Have mercy on your body, your heritage. Hallelujah. I believe there's a hymn for that. Hymn number 5, is it? hymn number 5. While we are taking that hymn, please. Hallelujah. We'll be taking the hymn, the trumpet will be going at the same time, and the ministers, please, let us come together. Please, the ministers, I don't know how many of us are here. I believe there's lots of us here. But I know that when we cry to the Lord according to the word of truth, it should be on that, like that day that Peter stood on the day of Pentecost and said, it was written. It was spoken by prophet John. Something will happen here tonight. Hallelujah. There are many ministers here. Please let us all of us stand. You can stand where you are while we blow the trumpet and let us cry for mercy to the Lord to spare His church. We are His church, to have mercy on us that are still living. Hallelujah.
Yeah, number 6.
In number 6. In my brother.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more. And the morning paints the table bright and fair. When the same old voice shall gather over all the other, and the world is full of wonder, I'll be there. When the world is full of wonder, when the world is full of wonder, when the
Christ, we first rest. himself. And we that are still in Christ alive may be caught up in the heavens with him and live with him forever. Forever means forever. That means death has lost its power. And on those that died, death lost its power. That is, as you hear the sound of the trumpet, death is losing its power. Many of us here are struggling with one issue or the other. If death will lose its power at the sound of the trumpet, that issue will lose its power right now.